Ever wonder what goes into making an animated character come to life? All the moving parts to make them convincing, relatable, and sympathetic? Animated characters have at least four different people coming together to create a moving piece of art. This series will focus on one character from animation and explore exactly who is responsible for making them come alive. Born in Bridgeport, Connecticut on May 6, 1916, Adriana was born into a musical family and began to sing almost before she could talk. Her father, Guido, taught music in New York, while her mother, Maria, had performed at the Royal Opera in London. Her sister, Louise, was a famous opera singer and teacher of Maria Callas. When she was a young girl, her family moved to Italy, where she was educated at a convent school while her mother toured with an opera company. When they moved back to the States, she didn't speak a word of English, so she studied the new language even as she took singing lessons. Her family moved to Hollywood, where she appeared in small roles, Naughty Marietta in 1935 and The Bride Wore Red in 1937.
Remember, I'm your cousin.
Then, one day, her father got a call from a Disney casting director asking if any of his students would be right for the part of Snow White.
My father, Guido Casalotti, was a singing teacher here in Los Angeles at that time. And one day, one of the Walt Disney representatives called his studio and asked if he knew of a little girl who could sing and speak as a child would. And I was listening on the telephone upstairs. It was an extension. I said, "Papa, how about me?" And I said, Walt Disney was not in the room to hear my audition. What I found out later was that he was behind a screen in the same room but in the back. And he didn't want to see anyone who would be trying out. He felt that he would be very much influenced by their looks.
She auditioned for the part along with 149 other girls. As soon as Walt heard her, he knew that she was perfect for the part. This, however, is where Adriana's story gets interesting. Although the part of Snow White made her extremely famous and proud, it hampered her career. Disney had her under contract and refused to let her work at any other studio, while keeping her idol at his own studio. He strongly believed that allowing her to perform in anything else would destroy the illusion that Snow White had created. She reprised her role as Snow White on a 1938 broadcast of Lux Radio Theater. Later, she was also allowed to sing one line on the soundtrack of The Wizard of Oz as the voice of Juliet during the song, If I Only Had a Heart.
Wherefore art thou, Romeo?
I hear a beat. How sweet.
In 1946, she played the singer in Martini's Bar in It's a Wonderful Life.
They love you, Bella. They love you for air or power. For your cantare, una canzone.
By the 1950s, Disney let Casalotti appear at his theme parks, on television, and in promotional events surrounding the various re-releases of Snow White. She attempted an opera career, but without much success. For her whole life, she was forced to be Snow White and no one else. Yet, her personal life was very happy, and she was always very proud to be the first Disney princess. At the drop of a hat, she would burst into a chorus of the songs that had made her famous. Whistle While You Work, Someday My Prince Will Come, and I'm Wishing.
Don't you remember me? I'm Snow White, and this is my friend Julie Andrews.
How do you do?
And we're going to sing to you.
We are standing by your wishing well. Make a wish into the well. That's all you have to do.
At home in Los Angeles, she proudly displayed a wishing well on her front lawn. Reportedly, Adriana remembered every line, verse, and nuance of her famous role.
Whenever I see little children, I do little parts for them like, "Please don't run away. I won't hurt you.
I'm awfully sorry. I didn't mean to frighten you.
But you don't know what I've been through, and all because I was afraid.
I'm so ashamed of the fuss I've made.
What do you do when things go wrong?
Oh, you sing a song.
You know, I still remember almost all the lines. I guess I enjoy it.
As she told a reporter in 1995, I know that my voice will never die. Adriana Casalotti passed away on January 19th, 1997. Thank you for watching this episode of Discographies. Click the thumbs up button below if you liked it, and if you want to be notified when the next episode comes out, consider subscribing. Further reading and references are linked below. We hope to see you in another Discographies.